one of our guys on Facebook, James, tell us about a location, which is kind of cool because, you know, we hunt all this stuff down, but it's kind of cool that somebody had told us that there was a location down here off of by Picacho Peak. And so we're heading down there now, and man, this road is a super highway, man.
It is pretty nice, nice and smooth.
And
the directions are adding up.
The road has got the most awesome name.
What is the name?
Cornman Road.
Cornman Road. You did like that when I told you to turn on Cornman.
But I don't see any corn.
No corn. Lots of cotton.
Yeah, it should be cotton
crops. Yeah.
So we're going to give this a shot. And so far, this looks really, I mean, the road is like unbelievable. So but I don't know what we're getting into or where we're going.
Right. So in 0.3 miles, we're going to make a slight left.
I don't know what that says.
I can't read it. If you can't read it, it don't matter. But we are coming up on some homes.
Well, that looks abandoned,
it
actually.
It does, but it's still houses, buildings.
G-Shrek!
James.
James, where in the hell are we at today?
The middle of nowhere.
We are in the middle of nowhere. And you know what's cool about being in the middle of nowhere, though, is when you're in the middle of nowhere, but you find something, right?
You don't even know what you're going to find, yeah.
Here's an old schoolhouse. And if we walk right over here, what we're going to find is a stagecoach stop center, right?
Something like that, yeah.
1879, right there, is when that building was first built by the Southern Pacific, but it was a horse-changing station. And who had ever thought in the middle of nowhere that we find something, a treasure like this, and it actually looks like they've tried to restore it. And that's pretty cool, and I believe that is the schoolhouse there. But then again, a gentleman took this over in like 1917 and made it a homestead. And this is really like a jewel that you just don't come across. I mean, look at this place. So here's the sign. It says a stage station and homestead. And it was 1879. And wow. Juan Verdugo was the person that actually homesteaded this after. And wow.
Pretty cool.
This is incredible.
We're
man, you know, one thing I want to look at real quick while we're here before we head on to what we're going to hopefully do see is petroglyphs. Is this old fence. And they would stack this timber after actually building kind of inner walls. And you see this a lot in the old, old places, but man, you don't see any of this left anymore. So if you look over here all along that wall.
The original.
It's the original.
And clearly they didn't want to tear it down because they just built newer metal fencing inside it.
And look at this pump right here.
Oh yeah, that's old timey.
That almost looks like an oil well. Wow. I'll tell you, James, this is like a jewel in the desert for sure. It is absolutely spectacular. Look at that thing. Wow. I tell you, this is, you just don't see stuff like this anymore. Look at this thing. I mean, this is a jewel, and I guess because it's out here in the middle of nowhere, you know, it's somewhat,
no one messes with
it's been protected, you know. And when you have a stainless tank, rot out. This has been sitting here for a while. And again, why would these crazy people be shooting this thing?
They shot everything around here, I'm noticing.
Stop shooting stuff, okay? If you're out here, quit shooting stuff. Get a target like everybody else does. Man, I tell you what, this reminds me a lot of the ranch. Now, at our ranch also, a lot of the wood was actually railroad ties.
Hey, cow. Hey, baby cow.
Dang, baby right there. Okay, so straight. Well, that's straight. That goes somewhere.
Our advantage, and SIRI literally says, Google Maps, that we are going to hundreds of ancient Indian petroglyphs. Every once in a while, this stuff pulls through for us, and Jeff doesn't have to yell at SIRI and Google Earth.
Well, you know, they haven't always been on our side, though.
It doesn't always add up. No, that's what's funny is today. It looks, I mean, we have no idea what we're getting to, so it could be completely.
This road's a little rough.
It's a little washboardy.
Consider it's all sand is bizarre to me. This whole deal is like bizarre. Take a look. Well, again, we did. I don't know about you, James, but I thought this was just going to be a quick in and out and be done. And it was going to be, you know, we're going to go off the highway. We're going to see a few petroglyphs, but I didn't think it was going to be a journey, and I didn't think it was going to see a real stagecoach stopping house.
Pretty
you
cool.
know. Didn't think in a million years I was going to find that or see that. I really did not.
I agree.
Something tells me that this is our turnoff.
I think.
Do you think this is right?
I think. Let me see what she says. 200 feet. Yeah, this is it. Yeah, because they're right there.
Well, I wouldn't have thought we would have found this stuff, James. I don't know about you out here. If you look around, I mean, man, we're out here today. We're out in it. There's no doubt about that.
I wasn't expecting this, but here we are.
And you know, this,
here they are.
This whole peak looks like, and most of it looks pretty archaic. I mean, most of it looks.
Yeah, it's like the abstract designs and stuff.
It looks really old. I don't see anything. And I'm hoping if we get up on that rim up there, that one boulder you pointed out up there has a lot. So I'd like to climb up there and take a look.
Let's go.
And see what's up there. And man, this is a great place. This place is really cool. Here.
Wow, that's cracked right in half.
Look at that panel right there, James.
Oh,
that's
wow,
probably the best panel we've seen.
There we go.
That's pretty sweet.
I like
it. We got them on the ground too, which is.
Yeah, I like those designs. We haven't seen a lot of those recently. When we first started, we were seeing them.
There's a good wall right here.
Yep, that's the one that I could see down there coming up.
This is the best panel so far, I think, right here.
Yep, this is clean.
Doesn't look like it got abused either. You know, something really cool is, at first I thought this was spray paint. It's so weird. I've not seen, you know, this is a bird of prey. And he's crapped all over here, and man, he's used this. You know, I look back there to see if I can see a nest of any type, and I don't see anything. You know, you just don't see that. You usually you don't see where a big bird has been back in a hole like that that I've seen. Not that it couldn't happen, but it definitely is not something I'm used to seeing. I'll tell you what, this is an incredible place. There is some, I don't know if this is modern over here, James, or not, but I can tell you that piece up on top up there is definitely old. This is a unique place. This really is a special place. More special than I thought it was when we first came here. That's old. This is old. There's a man out on that point out there, too, that's really pretty neat. Tell you what, my little shoes are, I'm happy for my shoes. Oh, it's right here. Let me set that camera real quick and I won't be able to see what I'm shooting, but is it on?
Yep.
It's right in here. I won't be able to see that because I can't swing around, but you guys will be able to. And then that guy right there and those little dots, that's pretty cool stuff right there. Look at our feet and what we're dealing with right here. And this is every time that you have a, when you think about spending money on a pair of shoes and you feel the grip like a cat, you're like, man, it was worth every dime, James.
Definitely, man. Not the place for my trail runners today, that's for sure.
We're gonna go up to this top and hopefully not fall down and get up here where the kings would be. You know, one thing, you can see people coming. No one's gonna be anybody sneaking up on you up here. Look at that view. That is beautiful. Now, I don't know if that's the old road, stage roads or not, but it just seems funny that these roads are this good out here when we're in the middle of absolutely nowhere. And these roads are still really good, you know?
Oh, absolutely, man. I'm surprised.
Oh, I just fucked it up. Too bad. That looked like Bigfoot. It's a nice little creature, whatever he is. So, you know, here's the thing. You know, I can't help that when I'm out here, I mean, there wouldn't have been much different from even 500 years ago. There might be more water, there might be a better water source, but I mean, this valley was basically the same as it is today. And, you know, it's what a beautiful place. We've just, this state is absolutely gorgeous, James. I mean, this place is just stunning. It really is.
And then literally just pick a direction and go, and you'll find really neat stuff everywhere here.
I mean, how beautiful is this? And just to be able to get to do this. So get outside, enjoy it, be safe, be careful. You know, we're going to start putting disclaimers on our videos because, you know, doing this stuff, I mean, you can get hurt. And we're not smart enough not to do the right thing always. So we're going to warn you to always make sure that you take your time, you be careful, you're ready. You're ready for the fact that maybe you're getting to a point where maybe you have to walk home. And you better be ready. Man, you know, here's what's funny, James, is the Casa Grande ruins is right over in that direction right there, right?
Yep.
So, you know, there's 3,000 people there. Now, in 1450, when that disbanded, all those people scattered, right?
Yep.
So, so many times we think there's only a couple places, right? They were all over here. Mm-hmm. There were groups, maybe 5, 10, 15, 20. But there was hundreds and maybe even thousands of groups. They were all through this area.
Yeah, this entire area. Yeah.
And you know, you made up a great point. You know, on the East Coast, they had just as many ruins, but they built over them. And because we have so much empty land, we see so much more of what's been left for us.
Yeah, it's been left more intact and undisturbed. You know, a lot of the East Coast cities were built, modern cities, were built right on top of old sites. It's pretty cool, man. This is a really cool view.
This is a beautiful view.
Yeah, this is pretty nice, man. You got this giant saguaro.
That's a good glyph.
That's a good one. Full rounded horn.
I'm not sure if Longcock Man, I'm not so sure he's new or old. He could be.
Where's Longcock Man?
Right here, this little bitty guy waving like, hey, look at me, because I'm big.
I got a big cock.
Looks like there's a couple weird I'm not sure about that one. You know, I don't know why, but you know, you just get these premonitions, you know. Now this is a crazy decipher, but this is what my gut tells me, so if I'm completely wrong, tell me. I'm saying Spanish. I'm saying cross, which I know the cross was here long before the Spaniards. But they definitely use the cross. Here is the guy, and then here are three locations, right? And I'm saying that's where we're at right now. So there's three locations something's at. What would be important to the Spanish? Gold, water. So that's what I would guess would be in these areas here. And that's just a guess. That's my interpretation. As wrong as I could be, James, that's what I'm feeling.
Well, that's what's kind of fun about this, because
you get to do what you want, right? There's a beautiful rock here.
Right here.
Oh, I'm gonna have to come down. Look at that.
Yeah, you need to see this guy. You like to see
that. Oh, they got a weird, there's weird circles on that side of that rock around that same rock. And I thought, and that's a cool like snake thing on that ridge. See, here's the thing, James, right here, right? Okay. This area could have been different. Hell, there could have been dinosaurs, right? But this rock here didn't move, right?
Yep.
Somebody stood right where I'm standing. Somewhere between 2,000 and 1,500, somewhere in that window, right?
Yeah.
1 to 2,000, and stood right here and worked that rock.
Absolutely.
And that might have been a little different, but...
The rock was there.
The rock was here, and he was here, or she was here. And that's pretty incredible when you think about even putting your hand on this rock, knowing that they put their hand on this rock. And I just, it fascinates me just to think that, you know, these people before us were here. And it's just like here's another falling man. Here's another dead man right there. That definitely looks like a falling man right there. So it's just, you know, they lived their lives, you know, 10 years, 15 years, 100 years. I tell you, this is really cool. This made my day, man.
This was a good one.
This made my day.
Oh, look at that snake.
Yeah, that one on the end over there.
No, right down below us, right at the little.
Oh, this little. Oh, wow! Look at that. That's the diamondbacks.
It's almost coiled, and it's got like a rattle.
Look at that. That okay. That looks like a diamondback.
That looks like the modern like AZ diamondback.
Yeah, that looks like the.
Doesn't it?
That looks like a diamondback.
That's a good one.
Man, that's where they got their logo. Now that's a lot of petroglyphs that are really interesting.
Here's several. All men, all little guys. And I say that because when we were at the dam, there was ones with boobs.
Really? Now, is that a shield on that guy right there? Or is that just a loop, a circle that's by him?
That looks like a shield and an atlatl.
Well,
a spear. No, look, yeah, or it could be a circle by it because there's one above it, but it would match up. There's definitely an attempt to make like a little weapon type deal next to him, though.
There's a pretty cool, There's that wave right up there to the right. See it? Don't sound so excited, James. Because bees are going to get you. Oh, this is weird. Yeah, there. This has been definitely... but you know, I mean, here's another situation, okay?
I would not doubt that one bit, dude. I mean, eventually we're going to have to get to a point where we start seeing wildlife.
Well, are we live?
Yeah.
You know, this panel here is probably my favorite. And you know, we went through the other side and we saw that this was a kind of a tunnel cave. And if you look on this side, you can see where the soil's been rooted out. Now, I don't see any paw prints or prints of any type, so I'm thinking that they rooted out from the other end. Now, we went in that other side, but that's fresh stuff right there. There's a cat or something lives in here. This is when you go, I wish I'd have had my gun on me, but I don't.
Oh, wait, you know what? Dude.
What do you see, James?
Probably up here. He scooted out by now off the hilltop, but there's like a whole...
Well, I saw the section when I went up there. You know,
you can see exactly where it would be the perfect place to live, dude.
I saw that when I was up there. I saw, like, from the other end, but I didn't see this rooted out. Like, you know, this has been rooted out. Definitely.
Yep. Sanctuary for some little guy.
Well, the thing I'm afraid of, though... is the word that you used is not accurate.
So Jay has been finding all kinds of animal homes down here today.
You know, I tell you what, I don't know if that's what all these mean, but look at all, there's a lot of these dots we've run into.
These are some interesting ones.
This is some, and you know, that stuff on the left-hand side is really old.
Yeah, that stuff has been around a while.
Not to say this is not new, but...
When we do our reading and stuff, we are by no means experts, but they refer to this as archaic, I believe. Is that right, Jack?
That's what I'm told. That's the oldest.
Archaic, abstract, and so that's...
That's a beautiful panel, though.
It is gorgeous, man. This is a really nice one right here.
I'll tell you, at night, you would definitely see some animals up here.
Oh, dude.
That's a cat of some type.
That's a bobcat up there.
You look in there. I mean, that's...
And
this
then,
is
the eagle or hawk one you saw down
there. Yeah, that's a big bird.
Sure.
That's a big bird. Yeah,
some kind of bird's living down here.
Yeah, maybe an owl. Maybe there's an.
Well, I definitely.
But you know,
owls to burrow and make little holes and stuff. They don't nest always.
You know, I want to give a big shout out to Brian Irwin, who had this location on Black Flag, and. We appreciate that, we really do, but we wanted to check places out before, you know, we want to have meetups every month coming up soon, and we want to make sure before we do it, how the road conditions are, what we're going to deal with, what you need, could you do it in a car, do you got to have a truck, things like that. This is an awesome location, and if there's a place that you'd like us to go to, man, we'd love to go, so just tell us where it's at. And if you don't want to post it, then messenger us, and we'll definitely give you a shout out. And, you know, the nice thing about this is that, you know, there's a little bit of graffiti, but overall, for this site being here for, you know, 1,000 years, it's actually in pretty good shape. What do you think, James?
It's in really good shape, man.
So, you know, so you can have a remote location and you can have people coming, and it doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to graffiti it and tear it up. That's kind of bullshit. So, you know, but let's make sure we take care of these locations because, you know, they were here 1,000 years and we want them to be here 1,000 years later.
This is a really good location, kind of a spur of the moment trip we made out here to...
Yeah, but you know, spur of the moment, but man, I'll tell you what, it just goes to show you just never know, right?
No, absolutely. That's what's so cool about it.
That's Stagecoach, man. That is so, that's like double though. You know, it's cool to see petroglyphs, but man, that's like double.
Exactly.
So,
well, you know, Google Maps referred to this as hundreds of Indian petroglyphs, something like that, ancient Indian petroglyphs.
So one for Surrey.
On this one. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe.
What about the notification bell, James?
Hit the notification bell, because then you'll get to know when we're on all the time.
But we usually post Mondays and Thursdays.
So if you hit the little bell, you'll know on Mondays and Thursdays exactly when the videos are up. We'll keep looking for places. Enjoy.
Jay's Wreck on the trail of adventure.